Hello. In this video, we will see Haldane effect. First, we will see the underlying process without Haldane effect. Then we will see the Haldane effect. And lastly, we will see how the Haldane effect affects the carbon dioxide dissociation curve. Let's get started. This is a peripheral tissue. We have seen in video of carbon dioxide transport that carbon dioxide diffuses from tissue to blood at peripheral sites. In blood, it undergoes multiple reactions and these things are produced. Carbon dioxide is transported in blood in these forms. Then, in video of carbon dioxide dissociation curve, we saw that partial pressure of carbon dioxide at peripheral sites is about 46 mmHg. At this partial pressure, blood contains about 52 ml carbon dioxide in all these forms per 100 ml blood. Now, for discussion of Haldane effect, only this portion associated with hemoglobin is important. So let's remove all the remaining forms and focus on hemoglobin. Now, the blood from tissues all over the body goes to lungs. Here, partial pressure of carbon dioxide is about 40 mmHg. Due to low partial pressure, carbon dioxide diffuses from blood to lungs. The step-by-step process is in fact reverse of what happens at peripheral sites. Hydrogen dissociates from hemoglobin. Then it combines with bicarbonate to form carbonic acid. This in turn dissociates to produce carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide also comes from carbaminohemoglobin. Then it diffuses into lungs and is eventually removed. At this point, carbon dioxide content of blood decreases to about 50 ml per deciliter. This is all without Haldane effect. Now we are ready to study Haldane effect. See, function of lung is not only to remove carbon dioxide. It also brings in oxygen. In blood, oxygen binds with hemoglobin. This oxygen binding destabilizes hemoglobin. So more hydrogen and carbon dioxide is released on top of those released due to lower partial pressure. After this, carbon dioxide content of blood falls even further to 48 ml per deciliter blood. This increased release of carbon dioxide due to oxygen is called Haldane effect. In a nutshell, Haldane effect helps release more carbon dioxide at same partial pressure of carbon dioxide. Now let's see the Haldane effect in carbon dioxide dissociation curve. Here, x-axis shows partial pressure of carbon dioxide and y-axis shows total content of carbon dioxide in blood. This is carbon dioxide dissociation curve. At peripheral sites, partial pressure of carbon dioxide is about 46 mmHg. It corresponds to this point where carbon dioxide content of blood is about 52 ml per deciliter. At lungs, partial pressure of carbon dioxide is about 40 mmHg. It corresponds to this point in the curve where carbon dioxide content is about 50 ml per deciliter. It suggests that 2 ml carbon dioxide is released per 100 ml blood. However, at lungs, partial pressure of oxygen is high. As we have just seen, oxygen causes release of more carbon dioxide, so higher partial pressure of oxygen shifts the curve to this position. The shift is nothing but the Haldane effect. In this curve, 40 mmHg corresponds to 48 ml carbon dioxide per 100 ml blood. And this suggests additional 2 ml or total 4 ml carbon dioxide release at lungs. Thus, Haldane effect almost doubles the amount of carbon dioxide released at lungs. If we see the entire picture, blood keeps shifting between these two points during carbon dioxide transport. Lower partial pressure of oxygen at peripheral sites helps load more carbon dioxide in blood, and higher partial pressure of oxygen at lungs helps release more carbon dioxide. Well, the discussion is complete, but did this discussion ring any bells with you? Something like Bohr's effect? If yes, congratulations. Bohr's effect applies to transport of oxygen. In this, higher concentration of carbon dioxide and hydrogen ions at peripheral sites increases release of oxygen. In Haldane effect, higher partial pressure of oxygen at lungs increases release of carbon dioxide. Thus, both the effects are opposite sides of same coin. That's all for Haldane effect. Want to make studying medical concepts fun? Subscribe and also follow me at other social media. At Nonstop Neuron, learning medical concepts is as easy as watching cartoons. Thanks for watching. See you in next video.